In the previous video, we learned everything there is to know, or most everything there is to know about inheritance. We learned that we could write a class, and then we could write another class that extends that class, thereby inheriting all of the variables, inheriting all of the functions, and then we could, you know, modify it. We could add some of our own variables, we could change a function by overriding it, we could do a bunch of things. Now what I want to do is apply this way of thinking to our particle system example. So here is our particle system example. It's a simple program. It has a particle system class, which manages an array list of particle objects. The particle objects are these little simple entities that have a location, velocity, acceleration, and that they fall with gravity. And there you are. You see them there on the screen. So what we want to do is say, I'm going to do something totally crazy. It's not crazy, actually. It's not crazy at all. I'm going to do something incredibly simple. Let's do the simplest thing we could possibly do with inheritance. Let's write a new particle class. The only thing that's different is it draws them as a square instead of a circle. Okay? So we're going to make a new tab. We're going to call it square particle. And I'm going to say class square particle. And now, instead of typing all of the stuff that we would normally have to add, and we need an update method and a display method, and we need all these vectors, and we need all this stuff, we're just going to say, hey, we extend particle. We just inherit everything that a particle has to offer, a square particle also has to offer. But we want to change one thing. We just want to override the display method. Instead of, I'm going to just add some stroke and fill. Instead of a circle, and it's with some size, and we'll say rect mode center, right? We're just adding in a bunch of stuff to change, to draw it as a rectangle. This is totally legitimate. We now have, you know, if you look at the particle class, there's all this code, all this stuff. We don't need any of it. All we need to say is let's draw it as a rectangle instead. The thing is, we did forget one thing. It's kind of an important thing, and we didn't cover it in the previous video because, you know, the constructor is always a source of confusion and in object-oriented programming. But here, let's take a moment, a deep breath, and let's figure out how do we write the constructor for the square particle. Well, let's for a moment go back and look at how the constructor is written for the regular particle. The constructor receives a p-vector. That's the object's that's the particle's location where it is born, and it makes an acceleration, and it makes a velocity, and it has a lifespan. So it does all this stuff. I have something to say. I want our square particle to basically be the same. There's no reason to make the square particle any differently. I just want to display it in a different way. So our square particle is going to be the same. How do we inherit a constructor? Well, it turns out that we do always have to write the constructor, and I can say square particle p vector l, which is, if you notice, exactly the same as the signature for the particle constructor. But what I can say is super L. I can execute this constructor in the parent class with the keyword super. And then I can give it the same arguments. So if I got this p vector argument, I want to call the super parent constructor with the argument L. So this square particle now is going to be born in exactly the same way that a particle is born. I don't know why I'm talking in terms of birth, but that's what the constructor really is. It's the moment of creation. It's when the object is created. So now that we have this, hopefully we didn't make any mistakes, I can hit run, compiles, it runs, and we see our particles there. It's the same. But let's go look at our particle system class, and let's just change one thing. Instead of when I add a particle adding a regular particle, I'm now going to add a square particle. And I'm going to run this. Whoa, there it is. I see square particles. Change it back to particle. I see circular particles. This is pretty magical. Look at this code. There's nothing there, just a new display method. This is really powerful. There's so much that you can do. What's so powerful about it that you realize is, if you build an elaborate physics engine, you could basically make that a library for yourself. And every single object you ever make has the physics engine embedded into it by just extending this kind of parent, body, mover, particle class. So this is incredibly powerful. Now, a funny thing has happened that you might, I'm like shocked that this is only five minutes into this video, and I'm going to end it in a second. But a funny thing has happened here. Notice that I changed this to square particle, and it runs, but my ArrayList still just has particles in it. So this is something we haven't covered yet, and it's called polymorphism, and it's what the next video is going to be about. But what I'm going to give, what I would say to you as an exercise now, if you're kind of following along and trying to do an exercise with each one, what you should do is try to make your own child particle class. Do something a little bit fancier. Maybe add, I got it, angular motion to it, so that it spins as it's moving. Maybe add, you know, the behavior is slightly different. Does it actually move in a slightly different way? How could you inherit everything but modify that particle class? So work on that. See if you can write, and if you're following along, the particle system example, you know, better way of organizing all this stuff, is the one that you can modify that I think is 4.3. So if you're looking at the examples in Nature of Code, go get example 4.3, find that particle class, extend it, and see what you can make. And the next video, we're kind of going to inspect this missing piece of why it is that we can somehow refer to this square particle as a plane particle or a square particle, and it seems to work. And that's going to be the topic of the next video. 6.5 minutes, that's amazing. Okay.